You always should ask for the final divot. Hi everyone, today I want to discuss with you the utility bills from the perspective of the landlord, who is paying for it and how much are they approximately. Quite often when I meet with my clients, they're asking me this question, so I decided to make a video about it as well. So basically, if you are a landlord and if you're renting a property on the long term, you don't have to pay utility bills. And by utility bills, I mean bills for electricity and water. And obviously there is as well bills for the internet. But if you are renting a property on a short term, so you have a tourist who is staying there or somebody else, basically any rent that is below 6 months is considered as a short term. So you can rent it like daily, weekly, or even monthly. In this case, you will have to pay utility bills and an internet as well. And utility bills in Dubai are quite high compared to other countries for obvious reasons. And there is as well changes in different areas, because in some areas the AC is included in the utility bill, and in some cases you need to pay to the third party for the AC, and the difference is significant. Even like in my case, I was living in different apartments, and like some apartments were more exposed to the sun, and over there I as well felt the difference in the utility bill. Here we call it DEWA bill, Dubai Electricity and Water Authority. And what is as well important is that the biggest part of utility bill is not like a bill for electricity or for water. The biggest part is a municipality fee. So what is a municipality fee? Municipality fee equals to 5% of the rent value distributed through entire year. As usually, it can go up to a half of your utility bill. So even if somebody is not staying at home that often, is not using the AC, the water still, the bill will be there, and they can be quite a big amount. And on average, and like it's really on average, because I told you there are different cases where you need to pay for AC and where it's part of the DEWA bill, I can say that for one bedroom the fees will be somewhere around like 500 to 600 dirhams, and for two bedroom it can go up to 1000. Again, it depends how many people are staying, is there somebody during the day at the apartment. And for villas, unfortunately, I don't have this information, but definitely it will go up, because you need to water the grass, and if you have a swimming pool as well, it will reflect on your utility bill. But basically, once again, if you are a landlord and if you're renting a property on the long term, you don't have to worry about it. If you are an end user who bought a property, yes, you will definitely pay for this, there is no question about it. And by the way, you as well will pay a municipality fee, which is equals to 5% of the average rent in the community. And as well, what is important to mention, that when a tenant is opening his account with DEWA, he's supposed to leave there a security deposit. So with this security deposit, the landlord doesn't have to worry that the tenant will have a big outstanding amount. But still, whenever somebody is leaving your property when the rent is over, you always should ask for the final DEWA bill. So final DEWA bill shows that there is nothing outstanding from the tenant, so you will not have any surprises. It's very unpleasant to go there and try to solve all these issues. And only once the tenant gives you the final DEWA bill, only then you need to return to him back the security deposit, and obviously if the apartment is in a good condition. So this is how it works in Dubai. Let me know if you have any questions about it. I'll be happy to answer them in the comments below. Thank you, and I'll see you in the next video. Goodbye.